These are the offices of Sumate. They don't like President Chavez, and the feeling is mutual. In fact, his government has charged them with treason. Let's find out why.
That's one of the questions I have for you. You've been charged with treason, your organization.
Actually, the actual charge is conspiracy to destroy the Republican system in Venezuela for receiving the first $30,000 from the net to perform those courses, those workshops on democracy.
Well, you don't think that you can be seen as part of the group of people trying to overthrow this government?
I don't know if it is a group of people, if there is a group of people trying to overthrow this government. I know that there is an opposition trying to fight for a transparent election to win the power of government through an election. If there is somebody else preparing to throw the government by other means, we don't know them.
You don't know them?
No.
Well, here's a signature of your co-director, Maria Corina Machado, on a document which is endorsing, what appears to be endorsing, the coup d'etat against the President Chavez.
Well, first of all, let me tell you, this signature appears on the 11th or 12th of April of 2002. Those were the days of the coup. This is the list of people that went to Miraflores, that's the presidential palace. And she, as you can see in here, what you have is the list of people that went and put their signature as a visitor.
She leads this organization. She is the first Venezuelan to ever be received by George W. Bush in the Oval Office, in the White House. This was in May of last year, and she had a photo op hand-holding with Bush, and then gave a press conference on the White House lawn. Now, one would ask, if this is really your grassroots human rights organization from Latin America, then what is she doing in an hour-long meeting with President Bush and then having a press conference on the White House lawn, the only Venezuelan to ever be received during the Chavez administration by the Bush government?
And she was involved in the coup d'etat?
Absolutely. She's a signer of the decree. She was in the palace the day that Pedro Carmona, who was the dictator that took over the government during the coup, dissolved democratic institutions and declared himself president.
Well,
she was there applauding and then signed as a witness.
Sumate's director says that she didn't know she was signing off on the coup d'etat.
Well,
she was just
having tea.
Yeah.
I mean, Venezuela's got the largest oil reserves in the entire world in one country. We're talking more than 300 million barrels of oil in reserves. This is something the U.S. government wants to get its hands on and wants to secure for as long as it possibly can.
Now, you said that you have more oil here than Saudi Arabia. You might be surprised to learn that an internal U.S. study from Bush's government agrees with you that you have, this is the internal U.S. study, that you have more than a trillion barrels of oil, much more than Saudi Arabia. Is this why you believe that the United States is antagonistic toward your government and that there are threats of assassination by Bush's allies? In other words, do they hate you because you're the Abdullah of the Americas?
Es decir, en otras palabras, a usted lo odian por ser el Abdullah de América.
Abdullah es un buen amigo, mi hermano.
Abdullah is a good friend, is my brother.
Mira, no tengo ninguna duda.
There is no doubt in my mind
de que el imperio estadounidense,
that the U.S. empire,
es decir, el gobierno imperialista,
the imperialist government of the U.S.,
está pasando en este momento por una etapa de desespero.
Is going through a period of despair.
Es como el conde Drácula,
it's like the Count Dracula,
cuando va saliendo el sol.
When it is dawn and the sun is pointing at the horizon.
Si no ha chupado sangre suficiente,
if he hasn't sucked enough blood,
entra en desespero.
He starts despairing.
El petróleo se agota.
And we are running out of oil.
Y el modelo capitalista,
the capitalist model
del imperialismo,
of the imperialism,
está en apuros.
Well, they are having trouble.
El consumismo de los países del norte,
consumerism in northern countries,
ha topado con un problema.
Is now run into a trouble.
No hay petróleo suficiente
there is not
en el planeta Tierra
in the whole planet
para sustentar
Earth
ese modelo irracional de consumismo
this,
y de despilfarro,
and waste.
Porque es consumismo
because it's consumerism and a terrible waste of
Luego, resources. A los Estados Unidos no les queda casi reserva de petróleo.
On the other hand, the U.S. do not have enough oil.
Esa es la razón fundamental del golpe contra nosotros aquí.
The coup d'etat against us.
Petróleo.
Oil.
Querían nuestro petróleo.
They wanted our oil.
Estamos hablando de 2002.
We are talking 2002.
Para luego ir por el de Irak.
And the idea was to then go to Iraq.
Y luego por el de Irán.
And then to Iran.
Aquí no pudieron.
Of course, they failed here.
En Irak no creo que puedan.
I don't think they are going to succeed in Iraq.
Ahora apuntan
here.
Sobre Irán.
Now they are targeting
es
Iran.
El desespero de Drácula.
That's the despair of Dracula.
Drácula petrolero.
The Dracula with the thirst for oil.
For a man who's been the victim of a coup, who's been threatened with assassination by the friends of the most powerful government on earth, Hugo Chavez seems remarkably assured, even cocky. I'm not sure I'd feel so sanguine if I were in his shoes, but he seems to feel that history or destiny is on his side, or if not destiny, at least the ghost of Simon Bolivar.
So, in other words, you wouldn't want to just have it out with George Bush in a sword fight, end it all.
La idea no es sacársela y hacer un duelo con George Bush con esta espada.
Yo creo que Bush le queda poco tiempo.
You know, Bush does not have much time ahead.
Bush le va a pasar lo que le pasó a Aznar.
You know what's going to happen to Bush? What happened to Aznar?
Se va a convertir en polvo cósmico.
He's going to become cosmic powder, dust, powder, cosmic dust.
No hace falta. Es muy grande esta espada
this
para Bush.
This sword is too big to be used against President Bush.
Es muy grande lo que significa.
The meaning of this sword is
Bush
too
es un minúsculo
Bush
accidente
tiny accident
de la historia.
Of history, a tiny accident.
Va a desaparecer.
He's going to disappear.